In this short presentation, we will discuss how to update reference year of the GTAP database. The Global Trade Analysis Project database represents a snapshot of the global economy in a reference year. For example, GTAP version 10 database provides a time series of snapshots of the global economy for each of four reference years: 2004, 2007, 2011, and 2014. With 2014 being the latest year added to the GTAP database. The latest reference year available in the database is usually a few years behind. For example, final release of GTAP database version 10 was issued in 2019 with the latest reference year 2014. If a policy of interest was implemented in a later year than the latest reference year available in the database, we may consider to update the database. For example, if we would like to model change in trade policy implemented in 2018, but the latest reference year available in the GTAP database is 2014, we may consider to update GTAP database from 2014 to 2018. Why update? Main reason is to take into account structural changes and changes in policies that took place between reference year of the GTAP database and year when our policy of interest was implemented. Then, we will use the updated database as a reference point to analyze the policy of interest. Another reason to update reference year is to validate CGE model with respect to variables of interest on historical simulation, and then use updated database for scenario or policy analysis. Let's look at examples. Boulanger et al. 2016 paper analyzed impacts of a food import ban that Russia imposed in 2014 on countries that applied economic sanctions against Russia. The analysis used GTAP CGE model and GTAP database version 9 that represents global economy in 2011. To isolate the impacts of the ban, a database update from 2011 to 2014 was performed prior to running experiments simulating the ban. The update took into account the changes in the main macro drivers, such as GDP, population, and factor endowments. The update also included changes in Russia's trade with its main partners prior to the ban during 2011-2014 period. Specifically, the database update reflected early Russian bans on Canadian and United States cattle meat and on European Union pig meat due to African swine fever. Ignoring these changes in trade policy would likely result in overstatement of the impact of the 2014 agri-food ban. Another example is Diefenbau et al. 2012 paper that studied sensitivity of corn price volatility with respect to effects of climate change on corn yields. One component of the analysis is the validation of a CGE model. Is the model able to capture linkages between agriculture and energy markets? The analysis uses a GTAP BOAZ model, a version of the GTAP model that allows for explicit modeling of biofuels, benchmarked to 2001. In the validation exercise, the global economy is projected from 2001 to 2008 using exogenous shocks. The shocks represent changes in macro variables, biofuel policies, and energy prices observed between 2001 and 2008. The model is validated by comparing changes in endogenous variables of interest to the observed counterparts. In this validation exercise, the endogenous variables of interest are corn price, corn output, and ethanol price. Changes in these variables produced by the model on the historical simulation were close enough to those observed historically between 2001 and 2008. This finding allowed these authors to conclude that the validation was successful, and the model captures linkages between agricultural and energy markets. The updated database, representing global economy in 2008, was used as a starting point in other simulations implemented in the paper. In the remaining slides, we will look at some elements typically included in updating simulation, and we will look at some specific components included in the update implemented in Diefenbauer et al. 2012 paper. To update reference year of the GTAP database, we run a simulation similar to other experiments with the GTAP model. That is, we use the model itself to create a new database. A general equilibrium closure employed in the updating simulation ensures that internal consistency of the database is maintained. The updated post-simulation database can be used for subsequent policy experiments. The update employs so-called baseline general equilibrium closure. Baseline closure depends on a goal of the update and is case-specific. Decisions regarding which variables we shock and which variables adjust endogenously in the updating simulation depend on the specifics and goals of the update. Macro variables that are endogenous in the standard GTAP closure may become exogenous and shocked according to historical change or future projections. For example, real GDP is endogenous in the standard GTAP closure, but may become exogenous variable in the baseline closure. Other variables that are endogenous in the standard GTAP closure, such as prices and quantities, may also become exogenous in the baseline closure. Let's look at the macro variables that are typically shocked in the updating simulation. Variables representing population, quantity of skilled and unskilled labor, and capital are exogenous in the standard GTAP closure, as well as in the baseline closure, and can be shocked by historical percent changes, say by changes from 2014 to 2018, if you would like to update benchmark year from 2014 to 2018. Corresponding shock statements included in the experiment file are shown on this slide. Update.har is a file with historical percent changes in the exogenous variables. Investment and GDP are endogenous in the standard GTAP closure, but may be exogenous in the updating simulation. To impose historical changes in GDP, real GDP variable, QGDP, is swapped with primary factor augmenting technical change, AFEREC, such that real GDP becomes exogenous and can be shocked, and primary factor augmenting technical change is endogenously determined to accommodate shock to GDP. The code of the standard GTAP model is modified such that the endogenous technical change augments only non-accumulable endowments. To impose historical changes in regional investment, investment variable QINF is swapped with slack variable CGD slack, such that investment becomes exogenous and can be shocked, and CGD slack become endogenous. But we cannot keep the swap for all regions. So for one region, we would have to keep investment endogenous. To impose exogenous changes in investment in all regions of the model, standard GTAP model needs to be modified. In Diefenbauer et al. 2012 paper, new variable and new equation are introduced in the code of the model. The idea is that global saving needs to adjust to accommodate changes in investment imposed in all regions in the model. The new variable is DP Save World, shown on this slide. It represents change in world saving distribution parameter and is exogenous. The new equation introduced for each region in the model links this world saving distribution parameter to region-specific saving distribution parameter. Then in the baseline closure, investment QINF in all but one region is swapped with CGD slack variable. Investment in that one remaining region is swapped with DP Safe Vault. As a result, investment variables in all regions are exogenous and can be shocked using historical or projected changes in these variables. CGD slug variables in all but one region and global variable DP Safe Vault are endogenous to accommodate exogenous changes in investments. Other variables that can be targeted in the updating simulation include prices, quantities, and taxes. For example, update from 2001 to 2008 in Diefenbauer et al. 2012 paper includes not only macro variables, but also sector-level variables that describe changes in biofuel policies and energy markets, both important for analysis of biofuels. Let's look at the update of sector-level variables. Change in ad valorem equivalent of tax credit for ethanol in the European Union is modeled as a shock to exogenous variable TO, representing percent change in the power of output tax or subsidy. Keep in mind that in the GTAP model code version 7, power greater than 1 represents a tax, and power less than 1 represents a subsidy. Sector output, represented by variable QO in the model, is endogenous variable in the standard closure. To impose historical change in sugarcane ethanol output in Brazil, variable QO first is swapped with variable TPD. Variable TPD represents percent change in the power of tax or subsidy on domestic purchases by private households. Output of sugarcane ethanol becomes exogenous variable and can be shocked by historical percent change. And consumption subsidy becomes endogenous and adjusts to accommodate imposed change in output. The use of consumption subsidy to accommodate increase in output assumes that consumers are subsidized to increase purchases of domestically produced sugarcane ethanol in Brazil. Finally, energy prices are an important driver of biofuel demand. World prices of oil, gas, and coal, represented by variable PXWCOM, price index of global merchandise exports by commodity, are endogenous in the standard GTAP closure. To shock PXWCOM in the updating simulation, this variable is swapped with technical change applied to global output of respective commodity, represented by variable AOSEC. For example, AOSEC coal is swapped with PXWCOM coal. Thus, output technical change in oil, gas, and coal sectors become endogenous, while global oil, gas, and coal prices become exogenous and are shocked in the updating simulation.